So a control program, so how does it actually look? Because I think some people don't really comprehend and conceptualize what's actually going to happen in the control program. So this is, I know the picture's not for the facilities here, but basically what we have is a facility in the UK that's going to produce the eggs for this control program. There is very high quality control within that facility. So we check every batch we send out for whether the genes there or not, the functions with and without tetracycline, the fitness of the males. So we check everything about that strain. In fact, we've had that strain for over 150 generations over the past 11 years since we've had this in the lab. We've seen no movement of the gene. We've seen no evidence of loss of function, nothing whatsoever. Very stably integrated, and it continues to work very effectively. So the eggs are sent to the trial site. Eggs of Asogyptite can be stored for up to 6 to 12 months, and they can actually survive in the wild for about that length of time, maybe a bit less because it's different, partially more in the wild. And this is one of the reasons that they've been so successful at going around the world, is that people lay them on tires, or sorry, Asogyptite lays them on tires, or other things like lucky bamboo. They get chucked into a shipping container, shipped around the world, chucked the tire out the other end, the next wrench out, you've got eggs to get invaded into your country or area. So we have a nursery factory or facility. We've got one here in Marathon, it's upstairs. The reason it's upstairs is because it's been built to be inspected by the CDC and the FDA. So they've inspected that and found it to pass the inspection in terms of containment and SOPs and how you're going to use it. You then hatch those eggs, stick them in trays, rear them with tetracycline, the antelopes, through to larvae and pupae, those little ones I've shown you before. And the pupae here, this is where the larvae metamorphoses into adults, like a caterpillar to a butterfly, exactly the same process. It turns into an adult. Now this particular stage here, the males are smaller than the females, and that allows us to size sort them through this special grid machine that we've got. And we can sort to 99.99% efficiency, which is roughly about 1 out of every 10,000 males that we release will be a female. Okay, over the course of a normal control program, so these are control programs going to Cayman, Panama, and Brazil, where we release somewhere in the region of about 3 million male mosquitoes to achieve this 90% control, we release roughly about 300 females over that 9 to 12 month period, which is far less than the wild type mosquitoes out there and does not affect the control program in any way. So we sort the males. The males are then basically put into, for this program, put into pots. They're allowed to emerge as adults, and then we'll take them out to the release site and then release them roughly every 50 to 100 meters. Those males disperse very quickly. Their only job really is to go and find females and mate and pass on the gene. And they only live about 2 or 3 days. So in a control program, we release about 3 times a week. Could be more, could be less, it depends on the fluorescent trace method, but basically about 3 times a week. And then we have these monitoring methods, the fluorescent markers, OmniTrap, which is a very simple pot with water and the medium for females to lay on, and these BG sentinel traps, which trap the adults to give us an estimation of the adult population that's out there. And we'll be using all of these to estimate population size, which we've done in programs, exactly the same as we've done in